Hello students, welcome back. In the previous video, we have continued with the reading of the story Fritz. Until now, we have covered pages 12 to 21 of the story Fritz. And today, I will continue with the reading of pages 22 and 23 with its detailed analysis. And also, I will discuss the characterization of our protagonist, that is the central character of our story, that is Jayanto. By the end of this video, you will be able to analyze the text and learn about the qualities of Jayanto. Students, keep one thing in mind, that you have to read the text again so that you can quote important keywords and lines from the text. Before starting the video, let us talk about the objective of this video. This video will cover the following objectives. We will try to understand the story, to build critical thinking, to create an overall understanding of and appreciation for literature and individual who produced the masterwork, to build reading skills. Now let us start with the reading at page number 22 of your Eco's textbook. At this question from Jayanto, I raised a reassuring hand. Reassuring means eliminating worry, and went straight to the gardener. As we have read earlier, that Jayanto the previous day had told Shankar that it was Fritz who had come back to life and visited him the previous night. It seemed that Jayanto believed in the supernatural elements, and that is why Shankar felt that it would be futile to talk to him. To help Jayanto get rid of such weird notions, Shankar suggested that they should get the earth below the deodar tree dug up to find anything related with Fritz. So that is why he talked to the gardener. After I had spoken to him, so he had spoken to the gardener, he looked at me rather suspiciously. Suspiciously means doubtfully. Clearly, no one had ever made such a request. Now, which request he is talking about? Why, Babu? He asked. So gardener was very doubtful about Shankar's request. That is why he is questioning him. I laid a friendly hand on his shoulder and said, "Don't worry about the reason. I will give you 5 rupees. Please do as you are told." So Shankar offered him 5 rupees and told him to follow his command, that is to dig the earth. He relented. Relented means agreed unwillingly, going so far as to give me a salute accompanied by a broad grin. Grin means wide smile. So the gardener agreed to Shankar's request, but he had agreed to it unwillingly. I beckoned. Beckoned means called to Jayanto, who was still sitting on the veranda. He rose and began walking towards me. As he came closer, I saw the pallor on his face. Pallor means unusual pale appearance. So Jayanto was being called by Shankar, and he was pale in his appearance as he was frightened. Whatever happened to him the previous night, it was because of Fritz. I did hope we would find at least some part of the doll. So Shankar was sure that they would be finding some part of the doll. The gardener in the meantime had fetched a spade. Fetched means brought. The three of us made our way to the deodar tree. Who are the three here? They are Shankar, Jayanto and the gardener. Jayanto pointed at the ground about a yard from the trunk of the tree and said, "Here." "Are you sure?" I asked him. Jayanto nodded silently. "How much did you dig?" "At least 8 inches. So which tree they are talking about? Deodar tree. And who had dug it earlier? That is Jayanto, when he had buried Fritz under it. So he had dug 8 inches to bury Fritz. The gardener started digging. The man had a sense of humor. As he lifted his spade, he asked if there was hidden treasure under the ground, and if so, whether we would be prepared to share it with him. So gardener was passing a humorous remark that if there would be a treasure under the ground, then they should share some part with him. I had to laugh at this. I here refers to Shankar. But Jayanto's face did not register even the slightest means smallest, trace of amusement. Amusement means pleasantly entertained. So Shankar had to laugh at the joke of Gardner forcefully, but Jayanto did not show any expression. It was the month of October and not at all warm in Bundi. Yet the collar of his shirt was soaked in sweat. So whose collar was soaked in sweat? It was Jayanto's. It was October, but he was soaked in sweat. He was feeling nervous at that moment. He was staring at the ground unblinkingly. Unblinkingly means not showing signs of emotion. The gardener continued to dig. Why was there no sign of the doll? So Jayanto was continuously looking at the ground which was dug up by the gardener. The raucous means loud and rough, cry of a peacock made me turn my head for a moment. And in that instant, Jayanto made a strange sound. I quickly looked at him. His eyes were bulging. Bulging means swelling. He raised his right hand and pointed at the hole in the ground with a finger that was visibly trembling. The narrator lost his attention for some time, but his attention was revived by Jayanto's strange sound, and when he saw at him, he was pointing towards the hole in the ground. Then he asked in a voice turned hoarse with fear. Hoarse means rough and weak. What is that? The spade slipped from the gardener's hand. I too gaped. Gaped means stared in great surprise at the ground, open mouthed. In horror, amazement means a feeling of astonishment and disbelief. There lay at our feet, covered in dust, lying flat on its back, a 12-inch long, pure white, perfect little human skeleton. To their utter shock, on digging the earth, they found a 12-inch long, pure white, perfect little human skeleton. Thus, the author has left the story open-ended for the readers to decide whether Fritz was a ghost or a supernatural being or just a figment of Jayanto's childhood imagination. I hope that you have understood the text with its detailed analysis. Now let us talk about the first character of our story. Jayanto. Jayanto is the protagonist of the story who worked in the editorial division of a newspaper. So Jayanto is the central character in the story entitled Fritz by Satyajit Ray. He is 37 years old. We came to know about this when the story opens. By profession, he is a newspaper man and editor working in the editorial division of a newspaper. A man influenced by memories. Jayanto was so influenced by his memories from past that he chose to visit Bundi in Rajasthan rather than visiting the famous places like Jaipur, Udaipur or Chittor. So we have read in our textbook that Jayanto is the character who relishes old memories. As he has spent some years as a child in a remote town of Rajasthan named Bundi, he opts to visit in the company of his friend Shankar, a school teacher, to that same place, rather visiting the famous places of Rajasthan. This was because he had visited Bundi as a child. He always wished to return to Bundi as an adult to compare the modern Bundi with his childhood image of the place. So the reason is being given why he wanted to visit the place, because he wanted to compare the childhood image of the place, that is Bundi, with the modern Bundi. Quiet and lost. Jayanto seemed to be a quiet man. He seemed to be lost in his past. He seemed to be in low spirits, to the narrator, the day they arrived in Bundi. His childhood memories with Fritz haunted him to such an extent that he felt depressed and emotional. After arriving in Bundi, he behaves strangely. Sometimes he is tearful and sometimes sad. Shankar, his friend, fails to know why his behavior fluctuates. Slowly, Jayanto begins to recall vividly the important places of his childhood: the circuit house, the memory of a deodar tree, the sight of the deodar tree in the garden of the circuit house plunges him into the vortex of childhood memories, and he remembers his toy, a 12-inch long figure of an old man named Fritz. A single child, Jayanto was the only child of his parents. He had lots of toys when he was young. He was so loved and pampered that his parents gave him practically everything. So we have learned from the text that how, as a pampered child of his parents, he had a lot of toys. Jayanto was not only loved but loving. When he got Fritz, he used to spend all his time with him. He could talk to his doll for hours. Perhaps because of being a single child, he was adamant too. Adamant means stubborn. When his parents warned him not to overdo things with Fritz, he did not listen to them. So we have also read about his emotional attachment to a Swiss toy that his uncle had brought for him was so strong that even his parents became concerned and scared. He would spend hours with the toy, that is Fritz. He would talk to him as if he were a living human being. Fritz did not, as he could not respond, but it seemed to the child Jayanto as if Fritz could talk to him, if he could speak to him in German. Now come to the next point, sensitive. Jayanto was a sensitive soul. He was deeply attached to his doll Fritz. He could not protect his doll from being destroyed by a couple of stray dogs. He buried Fritz as if a real human being had died. His sensitive self continued to be anxious even 31 years later. So Jayanto was shocked when Fritz was torn apart by stray dogs, which made him bury the toy under the deodar tree, which he discovers during his present visit to Bundi with his friend Shankar. Now let us talk about some of Jayanto's other characteristic traits. They are: he was a man of strong senses. One night when he was walked over by some strange creature, he was sure it had 2 feet, not 4. Jayanto was a diffident man. Diffident means lack of self-confidence. Though he seemed to like his friend's idea of digging the ground to free himself of his weird means strange, notions means an individual's impression of something known, he was reluctant. Reluctant means unwilling. So we have read that Jayanto lacks in self-confidence. When his friend Shankar gave him an idea of digging the earth under the deodar tree, he unwillingly agreed to his idea. He did not accept the idea immediately and was concerned with irrelevant details such as who will do the digging. In short, Jayanto is a whimsical, hypersensitive and emotional person. His obsession of Fritz makes him behave abnormally and erratically. So I have discussed the following points of Jayanto's character. Jayanto is a man influenced by memories, quiet and lost, a single child, sensitive, a man of strong senses, and a diffident man. So students, in this video we have completed with the reading of the story Fritz. And for your better understanding, you have to reread your text. Your homework is to plan question 1A on page number 31 of workbook. That is, describe the character of Jayanto with reference to the short story Fritz. Students, remember one thing, that you have to read the text again so that you can quote important lines and keywords from the text. Keep reading.